Why don't you give us
did it work?
Sean, because I keep on fucking it
keep
up.
Messing up, yeah.
We are on in 7, 6.
Five, four, three, two, one.
I know, you see, somehow it will change for me in these
it feels so wonderful.
Oh, okay.
I know somehow we're gonna get there. It'd be so
wonderful. It's all for me.
And telling you just how I feel is the audio coming through. I need to know this. It's your time to be. There's no chance unless you take one. Every time you see the brightest side of every situation. Some things are meant to be, so give your best and leave the rest to me. Leave it all to me. Leave it all to me.
All right, guys, welcome back to my stream. Thank you for tuning in. If you are tuning in, if you're watching this in the future, thank you for watching. It really means a lot to me. This is our first live.
Not even on the camera. That's the
well, look, I'm on this camera. It works.
They see your armpits. That's works. About it.
All right, well, how about this? Thank you again for tuning in.
We don't even see your face.
Well, you know what, Danny? Fuck you. This is my house. This is our
This is a Christian
this
stream.
This is
sir.
Our first. There we go. This is our first in-person stream or in-person session that we've done. Things are gonna be a little bit different. Not gonna have the whole gang here, but.
Because it's also Super Bowl Sunday. And
it is Super Bowl Sunday.
Like student athletes, so you know, obviously, ball is life. So they could not come to the escapism.
Also, my grandfather is dead, so I couldn't be there.
Get up.
Good.
No, we don't mean to laugh. Rest in peace. to
we all just have horrible senses of humor.
Truly, I think I started with Rand. All right.
Yeah.
So we're going to go ahead. We're going to dive in. Thank you guys for coming. A few announcements off the top. We're in person.
We're in person.
Yeah.
Minus Steve.
Yeah.
Minus Steve.
That's okay.
No.
Steve
is here in spirit. It's okay.
Steve is here, though. Steve is on the chat. Which is good to turn off non-video participants.
What? For Discord, just right click and turn off non-party participants. Non-video.
Oh, it says right there, show non-video participants. A lot of big. There we go.
Perfect.
There. Now it's a lot more streamlined. But yeah, so JJ and Mikey are currently prepping for their own Super Bowl shindig. So, you know, much love to them.
Sports loving losers.
Yeah, sports loving. We'll say that. With that being said, we're going to have a little bit of a side adventure type of deal. It is still going to be canon. Question mark? Depending on what happens.
I mean, Venusaur.
Venusaur?
Penisaur.
We should link that video.
You're supposed to know my moves, man.
The description. So. I mean, Venusaur? No.
I mean, come on, man.
My knee! My fucking knee!
Why'd you fucking evolve me?
Mikoto, I love you, Pikachu! Want me to lose?
I need nerves,
man!
Trust me, but we don't kill.
Yeah, we do. We do it for you, you fucking asshole.
I quote that so much at work.
It's so great.
And Tim does it right with me. It's fantastic.
Pikachu, go!
Pikachu, I choose you! Use
it! Well, he's charging his Thunder Smash! Use your bolt!
Lightning!
Lightning! Ow, ow, up, up. No, Venusaur, attack with whatever you feel like, man. Wait, what? I mean, Venusaur with a question mark.
We've gone on such a tangent. We are not even on a bunny trail. I feel like we're on a rabbit trail.
I'm warming up my RP skills.
Yes, but that being said, let's go ahead and dive into the recap. Who wants to do it? because I definitely took notes.
The recap?
I got it here. So, we started with you guys in front of the guard station. You had just received the terrible news that Father Valora was killed brutally on his way over to... Father Valora.
Open the wound again.
Father Valora was killed on his way to West Haven, the nation's capital. So, the party devised a plan. Medgar was still disguised as Captain Kane. The party devised a plan to grab guards' outfits for everyone to sneak into a hidden prison cell where they believed that Father Grail was being hidden. As Medgar goes to check, he sees only one open-faced helmet, so that plan didn't work. Medgar then decides to tell the guards to take off their armor, distracting them enough to get the party in without interference with the guards. The guards are told to go help the fire, and so they do, completely button, like, down to just their underwear, they go to an active, building fire. Smart. The party then makes their way into the hidden prison cell, where they learn Father Grail told some mercenaries that had the same tattoo as Athlin, where Father Valor would be and when. Grail then transforms into a were-rat, and combat broke out.
And we proceeded to kick his rat ass.
That's not far from the truth. But did number one, Zircon actually hit someone.
He said like that.
You're right. Zircon finally got a hit and did a significant chunk of damage. Not even gonna lie. Also, Rocco, I wish you were here. Rocco displayed a new ability in the form of spectral arms coming out from his back, adding to his reach, unlocking a brand new ability that he had not known previously that he had. And
straight up General Grievous.
Last but not least, the most important thing that happened, someone contracted lycanthropy.
HIV? AIDS.
Someone has AIDS. Someone here has rat AIDS.
Someone here has rat AIDS.
Nope. Yeah.
One of our party members contracted lycanthropy, the big one. Hepatitis B, baby.
Big one.
Hepatitis D. No.
D's.
The big boy.
After successfully subduing Grail, Athlin killed him as Medgar propped him up. Medgar then left the hidden cell and came face to face with Captain Kane, who arrested the party for and actually wrote down everything you guys did. Arson, breaking and entering, loitering, and the murder of a Xylean priest.
Loitering? We got arrested for loitering?
You got arrested for arson, breaking and entering, and the murder of a Xylean priest. And you got fined for loitering.
No!
That is where we are now. So we're going to smash cut. Not even smash cut, because we're going to open up.
Smash. Nice.
Smash.
Oh, smash. Nice.
Smash. No. That's going to be really terrible out of context in the future. I'm not a furry. I'm quoting Markiplier.
Guys, okay, just go and look up Markiplier's video that he posted on February 12th. Everything will make sense. Okay,
so
thank you very much.
We need a link in the description because, God, like...
The amount of references.
The amount of references. Yeah.
You're putting so much work on me right now.
I am sorry. I didn't start with the Pikachu.
Isn't the Venusaur thing a rigmarole? Isn't that a rigmarole video? Animation? Yeah.
It is an animation, yes.
That's Eagle, what's his face? Eagle...
I thought it was Rickroll.
No.
No, it's not.
No.
Eagle Raptor.
Eagle Raptor. Eagle Raptor, yeah.
Okay.
Eagle Raptor. Shout out to Eagle Raptor.
Okay. I'm gonna see this.
I'm never gonna see this. So just shout out to Eagle Raptor.
Eagle Raptor's gonna be the only viewer.
And Markiplier. Shout out to Eagle Raptor.
Yeah, and Markiplier. Yeah. He's gonna be listening, he's gonna be like, what?
Why am I watching a DVD stream? This makes no sense. Clicks out. So you guys are arrested. Everyone has been split up into separate jail cells. You have Rocco and Biggs who have been taken to their own separate jail cell. And then the party splits from there. With Biggs having been isolated, Medgar and Athlin are in their own jail cell, and
Buddy
and Zircon and Azel are in their own jail cell. Yes, because they said, alright, no funny business. Men with men, women with mimin. And,
Mimin with
women. Mimin with mimin.
You feedy business.
That has to be his voice from now on.
I know.
Mimin.
This one dude with a really, like, Salvador Dali blonde handlebar mustache. You know, just like...
Guy from South Park, the teacher. Okay.
Okay, none of this finny business. If you guys want water, you drink your own piss. Mimin with mimin and mimin with mimin.
Mimin with mimin.
Yeah, but no, so Captain Grail actually... Oh, sorry, Captain Kane.
Captain Grail's in the ground.
Captain Grail, no. Captain Kane comes up specifically to the side where everybody is, with the exception of Biggs and with Rocco and LB. And he just goes up to you guys and goes, question. What were you thinking?
Answer, I wasn't.
I'm with him on this
you
one.
You murdered.
He bit me.
We understand. Oh, wait, he bit you?
No.
We need to quarantine you immediately.
Wait, what?
No.
Nice work, dumbass.
His brother scratch.
His brother flesh wound.
Affleck, for some reason, this is the first time you're noticing this, but he's got like a massive chunk of his neck just bitten out.
Oh, God.
Like a friggin', like when someone takes a bite out of a gummy bear.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. He's just been holding
a just his uniform
pressure.
Bite, no.
Cloth just like applying pressure, it's dripping.
And then
just
like.
At this point.
It couldn't even be the arm, it was his neck.
It was his neck, yeah. So I remember it was a crit, so obviously it had to be a critical point.
Oh, I'm fucked.
Yeah, so.
If it was your arm, I would take my sword.
But yeah, you see, the captain is like, we need to quarantine this man immediately. See if we can get Bibby, like, in the room now. This man needs to be. Purged, clean, whatever, however we can do it.
Purged?
Father Grail had... Oh, he's dead now. Father
Bibby.
Grail had lycanthropy. If we don't purge that out of your system...
Bibby?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bibby?
Braxolomy Bibby, the apothecarian.
The gnome.
Oh.
I didn't know that was his name.
I thought you were trying to say Biggs.
No,
Biggs.
We need to get Bibby in here. get the apothecarian in here.
Like
see
Biggie
if we can...
Small.
Here's the medicinal guy that I stole his documents from.
You stole his documents? Where
no, I didn't say
now?
That.
Where are they now?
I didn't...
God, I have to add that to the list. Freaking... I have to add that to the list. Theft. Theft, I have to add that to the list.
Can I be eating bread at this moment?
Good job, man.
You found a... real quick, I need you just to roll an investigation check for me real quick. You find bread.
Okay.
I'm just going to see how good bread you found.
13.
There's a little bit of mold. You kind of just rip it off and toss it to the side. But otherwise, it's good bread. It's a little stale.
There's a fine bread. Brioche roll.
You see, he looks, he goes, how long has that been there?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, it looks like you ate the bread. You good there?
A rat jumped in my nuts.
I was like, are you mimicking throwing up or something?
Yes.
Ah! Bitch! Stop it! I love
Damn.
You.
See a rat fully trying to just like bite Athlon's balls as he's the one who killed, you know, Father Grail.
Can I take his tail and head and just rip?
Dude, it's your dog!
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
He doesn't like pointing.
Oh, excuse me. I'm so stop there,
guys. Oh, man.
Okay. Pause for 1 second.
Yeah, we can pause, absolutely.
Come on,
buddy.
Come on.
Oh,
come on.
I did not realize that was a trigger.
That was a trigger. You pointed at him and he went at attack mode activated.
Kill mode activated. Wait, what?
Okay. You want to silence this man?
That was like on cue. I know.
Do that to your dog. No, the rat runs away. yes. So, yeah, so he saying is, like, we need to quarantine this man immediately. Have any of you, you've all been exposed. We need to...
Isn't it just by blood, like...
It is, but blood? Also, I don't know... Here's the problem. The full moon is tonight. And you have not transformed yet, have you?
Nope.
As bitch, there's really no way I can explain this properly. Wait. Or legally, technically, because I personally don't know enough about lycanthropy. All I know is that at some point, if you get strong enough with your disease, you can hear him?
Maddie. Oh.
Sorry. That made it worse. It's like the disembodied voice of my master. But yeah, so you see Captain Kane goes, we need to transport you somewhere. We need to get you out of here. Because if you're next to these people, you will not have control of your condition and will attack them. You used the last of it to kill Grail.
Send him to Detroit.
So I took out two of my daggers and I did that.
I thought you did the arrow tips.
And I went,
you did the arrow tips.
I did one arrow tip.
Okay, so you only have 2/3 of a dose. You don't have the third
what,
dose.
It's something.
Okay. You tell this to Grail. You tell this to Kane, and he just looks at you and goes, okay, that's not a full dose.
It's still something.
I guess. I mean, do you have two? We confiscated all your belongings.
Yeah, it's in whatever.
Can you check to see if Rocco's can... Excuse me, sorry. I don't mean to interrupt. Rocco should have a weird freaking brain in his bag. Can you check to see if that's in there?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. a member of your party has a brain?
Yes. Don't ask that. Just check. It might not be there. He might not have it.
Okay, I don't know what to label that as, but that is a crime.
No, it's not.
That having a human brain.
Who said it was human?
Can I roll persuasion to try to get him to find it? Do I need to roll persuasion to get him to look for it?
Rocco and LB are currently not there. They're held at a...
Right, but they have all the... But Kane has all their belongings. So if the brain is in Rocco's bag, Kane would have the bag. So can I roll persuasion to get Kane to look for the brain in Rocco's bag?
I'm going to tell you no right now because he looks at you and goes, I'm not tampering with evidence. If there's a brain in there, and you just admitted to having a brain in your belonging, I don't know what brain it
but
is.
You don't know if it's actually there until you investigate.
What's the size of this brain?
Mid-size?
About yay. Point of the head, you know.
Like you know, like you know, like if you like you know, like a small baby.
A small baby. Oh
like,
god!
Don't say baby. Don't say baby brain.
Oh
baby
no.
Brain?
No!
What's wrong with baby brain?
You murdered an infant?
No.
It's no, I wasn't there. Okay, I didn't see it.
There was no infant.
Like,
are
you getting this?
Infant?
You see, there's a scribe that's just furiously writing. He's like, so much sad.
Write that down! Play tic tac toe.
He goes, now you've given my scribe an anxiety attack. Look at you.
This is probably over and pass out.
And he can't record the rest of what I'm going to say.
Can I jump at the scribe to see if I can get him to pass out from intimidation?
He rolled a 16, so no. See, he looks, he jumps back a bit, he goes, oh, you're behind bars. And he keeps writing. You see...
Wait, can he fake the mutation to make it
the transformation?
Yeah.
Do you want to do that?
No, not yet.
No, fake it. It's like, ah.
Yeah.
feels bad.
So, basically, you see, the captain looks at you all and goes, listen... I'm going to see if I can get in contact with Bibby. We're going to do what we can to... Okay, yeah, laugh at his name. Sure, whatever.
We're children.
He's a good man, okay? He's a great man.
You just in the back.
Listen, what I'm trying to tell you is that you might not have to get in touch with Bibby because we know how to make the potion and we have most of the components. And if you just listen to me and check Rocco's bag for the brain... That's one of the components to make the potion.
Again, I am refusing to tamper with evidence, so as great of an idea as that is, I cannot tamper with evidence.
So what's more important, your evidence being intact or this man turning into a rat, bursting out of here and killing most, if not all of us? Can I roll persuasion for that?
I'm going to do a contested, sure.
17.
I got a 19 on the dice.
Ah!
And Izzy can verify. So, yeah, see, he looks, he goes, listen, that does matter to me. Doing this by the letter of the law matters more. We can get it legally. We can get a Wolfsbane potion without interfering or tampering with evidence. We just need to get into contact with Braxolomew Bibby, and we can get whatever.
I think we're pissing him off, guys.
No.
See the scribe goes.
Are we pissing you
see
off?
See the scribe
off?
And he goes. Boobies. And just
wait, does he bite the boobies down?
Yes!
Wait, does this Ryan start going to drawing the boobs?
No.
Oh god.
Just a little side see, sketch. He looks over, he goes, don't draw that, just write it.
Those are amazingly detailed.
That's concerning. I'm going to see what I can do. Sit tight. There's got to be a way to fix this. I'll be back, and then you are all being held for trial.
Wouldn't be my first time.
What are we trying?
Actually, it would be my first time.
Oh, I hope it's new skin cream.
Are you all this dense?
No, just yes. Me. I just rubs off on people.
Are we talking like stone density or water density?
Dude, I'm the one with the 9 intelligence. I should be saying these things.
Anything or ale.
Well, thank you for that insight.
Have you tried Mala?
Mala.
You're asking me if I've tried the drink of our country.
Well, not branded the way I branded.
His branding tasted better.
He just kind of like, he just does this and just goes, I'm leaving.
Are we making the big soldier's brain hurt?
No, you're trying my patience.
Oh, you poor
goodbye.
Man. I'm not trying anything. As you can see, I'm standing completely still.
I thought you were eating bread.
I was, but it's gone now.
You see, the scribe is like, he has a plant there. See, the captain just goes, I will deal with all of you later. And if I...
Ooh.
Oh, are we playing
calm cards? Down, sir.
I miss you.
Do you have enough cards for us?
I won't miss you.
Oh.
Easy, you just turned around.
Oh, that's mean.
Damn, dude. That was mean.
So you cry?
Yes,
I cry. I rolled a cry. That one cried.
I cry. Wait, I threw you a cry. I failed. That means I do cry.
It makes you try to cry, but it's like really ugly.
Please don't leave me! I'll miss you!
Really ugly cries.
So he ugly cries for about another 15 minutes. And honestly, it's been a long day for him. I think, this was coming.
That's true.
Yes.
So, Athlin, speaking of Athlin, how are you feeling?
I'm great, guys. I killed the guy. And this is bad.
Yeah, this is a big day for Athlin, actually. So, first time you've ever murdered a man.
My arm burns all the time now.
You got a tattoo on your forearm that, like, is on fire at this point. Like, what else? Oh, yeah.
I put my arm around Athlin. I'm like, man, your first murder is always going to be your hardest, but it only gets easier from there, I promise.
Just like your first arson.
Just like your first arson.
I thought that's the easiest.
No one can prove this wasn't my first arson.
Huzzah!
Your booty cheeks handed to you. Some of y'all, others not so much, but Yeah, so basically the effects of a long rest happen. It's been hours.
How's Biggs doing?
Biggs, so what happened was they had like a medic come in and patch him up during this long rest. You guys were able to like rest and actually sleep. Bibby does come in during this long rest, escorted by Captain Kane and a few other guards. You see Braxolomy comes in and goes, "Oh, oh wait, then that's a pretty nasty mark there you got on your neck."
No shit.
Do you feel lightheaded?
No.
Okay, on a scale of 1 to 10, how is your rectal function?
I'm sorry.
What does that
Can I roll to see if I hear this conversation?
You are all, like, next to each other.
Yes!
A normal amount, I guess?
All you hear is, what?
you see, he goes, interesting. Cough.
Don't do it!
He just kind of, okay. So the only thing you contracted, thankfully, is lycanthropy. Which is bad. The reason.
Well, that's the good news.
The biggest reason is you could have gotten sewer plague, as he was a were-rat. And sewer plague is common among rats, especially in our area.
Great!
But you don't, because you are not having profuse diarrhea. And your balls do not expand on coughing. So, you are all fine.
When your balls reach critical mass, they go boop.
This is something serious. That I should be
that
looking
out
for. That
is a very serious condition called scrotal combustion.
Yes, I'm aware.
Oh.
Wait.
My father had scrotal combustion.
Raises a number
of
questions.
One of the altar boys got it.
Oh, God.
I need you to roll deception.
No, it's true story.
True story. So you don't have a scrotum.
No, one of the altar boys.
Oh, one of the altar boys got it. Oh, okay. I thought you said all the boys got it.
Is that the 10-year-old with the really deep voice that, like, looks like John Cena?
Do you not remember the kid, the massive kid with the massive forearms? Like, the altar boy who was just like, hey.
Yeah, that guy.
That guy.
That's the guy.
Aw, she's ugly.
Aw, she's
beautiful.
She's beautiful.
She's enchanting.
She's enchanting. So, beautiful.
Aw, she's ugly.
Finger little prick. Aw, she's ugly.
God. But yes. So. Yeah, so you see, he looks at you and goes, tell me, have you had any cravings for meat as of recent?
Does steak count?
Yes. Yes,
but I always want steak.
Okay, well, not much has changed. Then, you see, he opens up the patch and looks, he goes, you're fine.
That's encouraging.
You're fine. I'm going to roll a deception check real quick. You kind of believe him.
There's nothing I need to roll.
He rolls a 12 on deception.
Okay.
So you kind of believe him. There's something about the telling you that. He's not telling you the whole story, but it's just like, I guess I'm fine.
Can you tell me the whole truth?
I legally don't have to. So.
You're not wrong.
See, he
looks man, I love our legal system.
Oh, I have my own cell. So you guys, your cells are basically spaced. The only thing that's separating them is another set of bars. So you all have full access to communication and seeing each other.
Okay. Am I able to reach out and grab the doctor?
You are? Try a roll a sleight of hand for me.
Can I assist?
What'd you get?
13 plus... Nothing.
13. Great. Real quick, I'm going to roll for Kane.
I have zero slapping hands.
Let me look.
You got a... Okay, cool. So you see, as you do that, you just feel the... somebody grabs your wrist and goes, fuck no. Back to your cell.
Okay.
Okay.
And so he looks... So Bibby, like, looks at that real quick, goes back to you, Biggs, and goes... So, I can draft a bottle of Wolf's Bane potion, one dosage. It'll take me 2 hours with the ingredients I have.
You have a brain that contracted what he has.
I would like, you see, Kane comes and goes, we can't do that. That's
okay, evidence. Well, here are your options. Either we get the brain.
That's evidence.
I like him. Either you get the brain and use it for the potion, or you don't, and he turns into a were-rat and eats all of us.
Wolf. You see, he looks, he goes,
do we still have the cadaver?
The what?
The cadaver. The body.
Oh, he means dead guy. Yeah.
I'm guessing.
You see, he looks over at Captain King and goes, yeah, we have the body. Great! I will need a sample of semen.
What?!
What kind of potion are you
semen
making?
Semen has
there?
The most concentrated amount of lycanthrope DNA that you can find.
Well, you learn something new every day, I guess.
You can roll inside, sure.
Nat 20.
That is a 6.
Six plus 6, so 12.
Can I look to see insight for his intentions,
you know,
with
plus
my body?
6 to insight? That's insane. Yeah. Yeah, with a 12, you look at him, he goes, you think, you don't think so, but, you don't think so. He knows a lot of the altar boys very well.
Wait, what did you say?
I don't think so.
Can I roll insight?
You can roll insight, sure. You can roll insight, definitely.
Okay. Fuck, I know. Oh, well,
yeah,
with an 11.
Okay, with an 11, he explained to you what he was looking for as far as, like, sewer plague.
Okay.
And that's about the extent that you know, so that's about all you can accept, is that he was just checking for sewer plague and potential scrotal combustion.
Lovely.
So you see, he goes, well, my job here is done. If I can find a sample of lycanthrope semen, not yours, I can have it done in 30 minutes.
Thanks.
If I just have blood or skin or
brain.
You see, he goes, not brain. Can't tamper with the evidence.
It's a brain.
It's an evidence.
How is that evidence?
What are you going to do? Do DNA testing? That hasn't been invented yet.
I held him up like a chicken and I skewered him.
Okay.
And I ripped his ribcage out.
Scribe, you got that? I got that, sir.
Yeah.
Okay,
great. I'll do it to you next.
That's a threat. We have to add that to your list. I kid, man.
Man,
listen.
You're a bitch.
Man, he's like, he's writing this shit down like groceries, man.
But I'm just trying to do my job. I don't even, okay.
Man, fuck your job.
You know what? Honestly, I wish I could just say screw it and leave
you
and go
can.
Back home.
You
I
can.
Legally can't.
Yeah,
I literally cannot.
You guys and you're legally. I legally can't.
You legally should be dead.
I legally should be dead.
I'm going to escort the good doctor out. You see, baby goes, oh, I'm not the doctor. He goes, we're not going to dive into that.
Wait,
and just
what?
Take him out. Escorts him out.
Motherfucker's not a real doctor.
He's just following your balls.
You see, the scribe is like, well, yeah, he that's why he's an apothecary, not a pharmacy, or even a clinic. Duh. It's like holistics. And, like, walks out. So you got your balls fondled by a holistic medicine man. And,
not something that happens every day.
Not something that happens every day, no. So yeah, we'll say the rest of the long rest happens. And say, because you guys got in there at around 7, a long rest is 8 hours. So that would be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. 3 a.m. 3 a.m. You guys wake up. And Sean has left the room. Got it.
I'm still listening.
Okay, cool. You guys wake up. And everybody give me a nature check.
Thirteen.
Oh, snuggle beast. Oh, well, you took a long rest, so you get everything back. But the short rest, we'll explain that later.
Damn, 7.
Oh. Okay, so, 21. Hazel, you have a background of a druidic upbringing. You were taught when to suss out when something is wrong. More importantly,
sauce. There
is a specific language that druids speak. It's literally called druid speak. And it's not a verbal language, but it's a different kind of language that is felt and sensed. You know? It's like breeze in the wind or the rustle of leaves.
Feels like somebody wants to sell me something.
It's an MLM, fog. You all wake up to fog rolling into the prison. Hazel, you sense that this is not natural, but magical, as in this isn't a normal occurrence here. Somebody conducted this fog to come in, and you can also sense that it is druidic magic with the 21.
Okay.
You guys hear shuffling from down the hall. Your prison cells are lined up as such that you can't see it until they are roughly 5 feet within visual distance. But up to this point, you only hear like soft shuffling. You hear, I'm going to say with that 21, you also hear the distinct sound of animal bones kind of rattling together, and you smell the distinct scent of like wet bark and moss and morning dew specifically. Like these smells of damp nature linger on this person.
Okay.
Eh.
Kind of gross.
It's like a Yankee Candle.
Nature Man. From Yankee Candle. Shout out to Yankee Candle.
Sponsor.
Yankee Candle. Sponsor. Palma Breeze.
I'm not linking that.
I'm not linking that. Shout out to Yankee Candle. No.
Shout out to Yankee Candle. Make the new flavor ball fondling apothecary.
Flavor.
Flavor.
I am very concerned with what your diet consists of. If you're eating Yankee Candles.
No one else eats the Yankee Candles? You mean so like when it's all melted, you don't drink it?
Oh god.
Nobody?
You're supposed to stick your head in it.
I thought you were supposed to stick your finger in it and then let it like harden around your fingertips, you know?
Oh, yeah.
That's weird.
Yeah. Yogi,
that's messed up.
Okay, yeah, so I'm not the only one who does that. When, like, it actually melts like a puddle, you just kind of, like, stick your finger in and let it, like, harden around your finger. It's the weirdest...
You can do your whole hand.
Yeah, it's the weirdest feeling, but it's so cool when, like, crackles.
Your hand feels so soft.
Yeah.
See, all that makes me think of is Dark Souls 3.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If you played it, you know.
I have not.
Oh, sad boy times.
Sorry, going back to setting the scene. You hear the shuffling come closer and closer as the fog rolls in thicker and thicker. Eventually, you see this person come in. They are wearing a long shawl, just a long fabric of cloth thrown over their head. You see that they are up to their waist in fog. You can tell from the footsteps, Hazel, and I'm going to say Zircon as well because you got 16, this person is barefoot. They're walking on stone, shuffling at it like a little bit at a time. And then Hazel, you can hear the difference between like soft bare feet and like calloused bare feet. This person has very thick calluses. The scent of nature and pine sage is very strong as the closer they get. And you see they stop in front of Hazel and Zircon cell and turns. And you see him reach a hand into the cell. And you watch as a small flower grows from his hand. You don't see his face. You can't tell any features or anything. You just see a small flower grows.
Can I pick
for
it?
Me?
Both of us? Get me it now!
Oh.
So, see, he just kind of like... like straightens up like, and then the flower gets picked by Zircon. Goes,
and then I hand it to
him. Oh, thank you. That's good.
So he just goes and grows another one. so you see he...
Hey. I'm gonna stick it in my hair.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. So
but you see he points to you, Hazel, and, like, does this with his hand, just kind of curls his fingers in, motion you towards him.
I'm going to slowly approach him, but stay out of arm's reach.
Okay. You slowly approach, and as you approach, he backs up as well. So
okay.
Keeping arm's reach.
Abort. Abort.
As you step closer to the door of the cell, you feel the stone slowly turn into grass. As if where he steps, and you look down, you see where he stepped, there is like a 5-foot range of grass. So as he continues walking, you see the grass follows him. And you see he waves his hand, and you watch as vines creep up the door and make its way into the lock and break the lock by, like, overgrowing and just... And so the door is open.
Oh, well, thank you, sir. What is your name?
You were met with silence as he waves his hand and unlocks the rest of the door.
Wait, it's already a full moon, have I?
Not yet.
Okay.
In fact, actually, roll me a insight or nature, and anyone can do. I'm gonna say Hazel specifically can do this with advantage. Zircon can roll as well. Everyone can roll, but Hazel rolls with advantage.
13.
Cool.
7. Good lord.
Let's go.
15.
Okay, cool. Athlin. Everyone else kind of assumed, like, Hazel, I'm saying you're assuming that it's got to do something with the guy. Athlin, you know divine intervention. Like, you know divine auras when you feel them. Mm-hmm. You felt them in clerics, you felt them on paladins. This man has a druidic natural aura about him that is suppressing the effects of the full moon on Biggs.
Okay.
That's what you get with the mod 20, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's doing something weird. That's all I can say. He's just doing
what? Something. No? Having the vines coming out of the ground and unlocking the...
A wheel!
See, he looks at all of you, he goes, is this all?
Oh, what?
Did you get the big dudes that are in the other cell?
I did not account for them. You will have to do it.
They'll be fine.
Who are you?
Father.
He's our ticket to fuck out of here.
He walks out and, Biggs, you feel as he gets farther and farther away from you, the pull of the moon gets stronger and stronger.
Oh, great.
The door is open for all of you.
I'm following.
I'm
going to
follow.
He just set me free. I'm following
him. I'm following Grassman.
Yeah.
So you guys all follow Grassman. And as you guys leave the area, he looks around and goes, stay close. See, he waves his hand as the fog builds. You guys all get a plus 10 to stealth checks while you guys are near this man.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. You guys make your way through the town. I'm going to need you to roll stealth checks for me.
Well, I guess that makes it a 13.
Modified 23. You got 30
plus
10?
Yeah.
15.
Plus 10.
So I have a modified 33.
You got 29. 39. You got 33. Yeah. So, with the fog billowed, the pass was a 16. So I think all of you passed.
Not me. I got 13.
You guys did?
With the plus 10?
What'd you get?
Yeah, with the plus 10. I got 1 plus 2. I got a nat 1.
So you see, as you guys are sneaking your way through the town, their guards are on, the guards are on alert right now. A major member of the church has passed away. He's been killed, and they are trying to make sure that there is no funny business or escape going on. And you guys are walking past these guards. The good thing about being cloaked in this fog is that they cannot see you. The bad thing is you also cannot see what's too far in front of you.
Of course.
So to the back is Zircon, and where did Steve go? Did he turn off? Steve, you turn off the video?
Steve.
I didn't hear him.
I'm back.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I have to go. I have to go get my dinner really quick. I'll be right back.
Okay, sounds good. We'll pause.
Okay.
There's pizza out there.
Ooh,
so.
This is a good point to stop. Pizza.
Yes.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm okay.
Bye, buddy. For tomorrow. Look, hey.
Yeah. Oh, phenomenal.
Phenomenal.
11 out of 10.
11 out of 10.
Best ass I've seen all day.
Are you home up?
We're good.
No waiting.
Stop.
No, he's doing the 0-2 dance.
No, no, not the knuckle. Not the knuckle.
What?
Not the knuckle.
I'm a little scared.
You hear a knuckle. It's a thing.
The old hairy knuckle.
The old hairy.
That's rough, brother.
That's not that
hairy.
Mine is very.
I'll just get you in that little pressure point. Right there. Make sure that you also look jello.
My spider sense was tingling.
Yes. You can see me in the camera.
Web test. Alright. And just like that, we are back.
Yes.
Yeah. Alright. We are back. We had a very short bio break. Thank you for coming back. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for staying. Sponsored by YouTube.
No one's watching.
Sponsored by DiGiorno. We got it delivered. no. Not spawn. Hashtag not spawn. But yes, so you guys were following. We had two people who failed their stealth rolls. You know, with the plus 10.
Who was that?
Me.
I don't
want to
talk about
it.
The sneaky Skyrim archer.
So as I was saying,
since we all rolled high, can we like pick them up?
Oh, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. So as you guys make your way through the town, you guys are very close to these guards. Like you're passing by them occasionally, hearing a few bits of dialogue, such as,
"Oh, is this folk is unnatural? Where all these folk come from?"
I heard there's a witch. There's a witch in the woods. And that's all you get if you guys are continuing to walk by. You see someone going. You see another person as you watch. I guess.
Those damn kids are playing with them fast starters again.
And you continue and you hear one guy go, "Listen, I just want to go home, man. I just want to go home. Like, I just want to." Ah! And as someone steps on their foot. And you see, he goes, "Ah, what the fuck? Wait, someone in here? Someone in the fog?" And you see, they like sweep, and they hit one of you guys. And go, "Yeah, hey, there's some." And you see this dude in the cloak turns around and says some incantation. You see their hands glow green, and you see the guy in the middle of talking goes, "It's someone go ah!" as a tree grows out of his mouth.
Oh my god!
Oh, he dead.
And roots him there.
Oh!
And you see, he goes, "All right, it's not going to stay for long, so we need to move."
He's dead.
He's not dead.
That's horrifying.
He's temporarily with
us. He's not dead?
He's in excruciating pain, and he will come to in about an hour or so after it goes away. But as of right now, he's just held in place. We don't have much time. Let's move.
Oh,
that poor man. Listen, that poor man was going to send you back to the stockade. Now, are we going or what?
Following you, man.
Grass man.
You guys follow grass man. Outside of the city gates, to the city gates, and you see, if you look on the map to Goldcrest, you see there is walls and entranceways. We were just there. Walls and entranceways to the city, the main road. However, those roads are blocked off right now. There's no way out of the city. They're trying to make sure you guys don't escape. And you see Grassman looks and goes, "Well, onwards and upwards." You see he like waves his hand and you see vines grow up the side of the wall. And you see he looks, he goes, "All right. The guy who just ate a tree no longer is eating a tree. He's probably going to alert someone. We need to get him to go fast." I need everyone.
Took an hour to do?
He said, "No, I had to change concentration."
I understand because I do magic and stuff.
So I need you guys to go ahead and roll me dexterity checks. Either athletics or acrobatics, whichever one you prefer.
Oh, what the fuck?
16. Oh my god.
What the hell?
3.
I rolled a nat one again! Two nat ones in a row!
Because you were rolling 20s before we even started.
I know!
So as the rest of you guys make your way up, Grassman stays on the bottom, making sure you guys go up, and... you see Medgar is climbing. He's climbing fast, and flips his hand where Zircon needs to point her foot, and so she steps on his hand, immediately is like, ah, and it grabs, just instinctively, and so the two of you start falling, and you see Tree Man goes, fuck, and just like, a tree bursts from the ground where he's standing, surfs up and like catches you with branches, and opens up over the wall, and he goes, well, so much for stealth, get down.
Run!
And jumps over and lands on the ground with a little bit too much ease. And he goes into the woods, follow. And he.
Into the woods.
You see him get down on all fours and shift. His body shifts. You see his.
Ooh. Ooh.
True man.
Oh, Tree Man! Can we roll for thickness?
No.
Oh, Tree Man! Are we gonna roll for girth?
Grass is grass, and I'm gonna mow it.
You gotta roll for girth and bushiness.
Oh, God. Oh,
at the
hey,
base. You gotta trim it, because then it looks bigger.
Your ass is grass, and I'm gonna mow it.
Okay, so you see he shifts his body, is transforming. The only other time you guys have seen something transform is with this were thing. However, this time it's different. Hazel, you recognize this as a druid wild shaping. They transform into a beast of choice. And you watch as his hands form together to make hooves, his limbs elongate as his neck stretches, his face begins to stretch and change as antlers protrude from his head. You see he shakes the cloak off and it forms down, slides onto his back, and you see before you is a majestic white-tailed deer with beautiful large antlers, vines woven between them. You see he looks...
Are we talking like a 7-point buck? 8-point buck?
We're talking like 8-point, easy. So he just looks and like bows.
12-point.
Jesus fuck.
12-point. He's a 69-point buck.
It's just Xerneas.
He's a big boy.
Damn boy. He's a thick ass boy.
I'm sorry. That raises more questions that I'd like to go into. No.
It's a 9-point. There you go.
So, you see, he looks, and you hear the guard starting to, like, shout and such, and you hear the gate is beginning to lower. And you see the deer man looks and books it into the forest.
Yeah, man. Right after.
Yeah, we're right after him. Yeah.
Alright. So you guys run after him, and I need...
Any dexterity checks from everyone?
Oh, you got this.
Just base dexterity.
Either athletics or
15.
Or athletics or acrobatics, whatever your choice.
Thank God, a 19.
God, by 20.
The curse is broken.
19.
29.
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Me and Medgar are just rolling.
You guys are following this deer. This deer is weaving its way through this forest with ease and grace and elegance, and you guys are matching him beat for beat. You watch where his feet step. Hazel, you follow, and everyone follows Hazel. Hazel, you're in your element. You were raised in this kind of environment with this overgrowth of trees and in the denseness of the woods. You know this terrain. So when you're when your task is to follow deer, easy. All day, every day. and you find yourself weaving and going and flowing through the brambles and the bush, and eventually the deer stops in a clearing and shifts back to his human form. And now you see that the shawl is no longer over his head, but it's around his shoulders as he goes from deer to man again. You see he has a 7-foot frame. No.
Damn it. Don't you dare.
We don't talk about him. No.
No, we don't talk about him.
This, I'm sure this is going to date this very, very heavily. But you see he looks, and he does have shaggy brown hair, like bits of twigs and leaves kind of scattered in it. He has a full bushy beard. Dude looks hungry, but not in a way that's unhealthy, just kind of in a way that he's like a vegan who's trying to cut his like macros.
Tone.
You know? Yeah, exactly. Like he's, you see like his forearms are exposed now. This dude has like ripcord coiling like muscles. Like he moves his hand, you see every tendon move, and it's like impressive. You see he looks, he goes, "Tell me, are you a child of the Grove?"
What?
Child of the Grove?
What do no. You
mean? I wasn't asking you. I wasn't asking you.
I thought you said yes, Grove.
Yes, I am.
Beautiful. Okay. You can help me.
I can help you.
You can help me, yes.
How can I help you?
You see he looks over his shoulder, he goes, can I trust these people?
Oh, of course. I trust them with my life. Literally.
I assume so. So I freed
them. I've known you for like 2 days. That's pretty something.
And he set a house on fire. Allegedly.
Allegedly.
You can't prove it.
That's terrifying. I do not know how
it. It would be terrifying if it were true.
Oh, okay. Great. Allegedly. Anyways, back to what I was saying. My sister of the Grove, I need your help. One of our kind has been tampering with the magics that we have access to. They have been creating abominations, unnatural creations that serve one purpose and one purpose only: to kill. Real quick, I need you guys to roll me a history check.
Oh boy, I have a -1 in that.
Yeah, so you don't.
Oh boy, that's a 5.
I got a 16.
Or 20.
All right.
Great. I got a 3.
Okay, cool. Excellent.
I got 3.
Anyone who got above a 10, you remember the bounty board that was posted in Goldcrest, help wanted monster in the woods attacking travelers, reward 50 gold pieces for pelt. And it said ask for then I think I have his name down.
Fentanyl?
No.
That's what I heard.
Fentanyl?
No,
I have his buddy Adderall.
Forgive me, I got so wrapped up.
Didn't know we were moving spice to these points.
Forgive me, I am looking for it. Oh, Fendithus Birchkind. Fendithus.
I'm going to call fentanyl.
Fendithus Birchkind. Fendithus Birchkind. JC. I'm changing the pronunciation so y'all can like repeat it, so it's like actually pronounceable. It's Fendithas.
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 Bend your ass.
Birchkind. So you see, he introduces himself. He goes, "I put the ad out about a week ago, hoping to get some help from civilization. Even though I don't like them much, I am Fendithas Birchkind." Fen. What's so funny? I feel that I'm missing something.
Don't worry about it.
Oh shit, this is in character.
It's Fendithas.
Oh shit.
But you can call me Fen.
Fendithas.
It's Fen. You can call me Fen. I understand that.
Hi Fen, how are you?
I am doing quite well.
Please tell me his quad's like a god.
He is the you see he's like wearing like very loose trousers, but they are absolutely like skin tight around his thighs.
Only his thighs though.
No, because they don't taper. They don't taper. They don't taper. No, they're just straight, like,
I'm thinking they're, like, super thick around his thighs, but his calf muscles are just, like, puny. It's so they're all, like, wavy and baggy.
It's like your standard CrossFitter.
So it's like my thighs with your calves.
Yeah, it's your standard CrossFitter, you know? He's got, like... Yeah.
Oh, God.
No, this is recorded.
Oh, no.
No, this is on camera.
Oh, no.
I'm not
out
there.
No.
Oh,
shit. He's gonna watch this, too.
He
went
to Jared. Oh, God. I hope so, and I also hope not at the same time.
He can take a joke.
But yes, so, you see this guy, he asks, can I get your names?
Biggs.
Zerko.
Halfman.
Medgar.
No.
We love Aww. You, Steve.
The octopus is sad.
Oh, poor octopus.
Wait, the black side, is it even like, is it the angry octopus? Yeah.
It's not angry, it's demonic. We love you, Steve.
We love you,
we
Steve.
We miss you.
Yeah.
I know you do. I don't know about Sean, though.
I was the one who offered to pick up from the airport.
Fair, fair.
I texted him the address. I was there.
Yes, I texted you everything.
But yeah, so you see Fen looks and goes, the creator of these monsters is resting at this moment, but if we move fast, we can get a jump on them.
We kill him while he sleeps. Good idea.
I will give you 50 gold pieces per pelt. And you have my... Yes, per pelt. We will skin these things.
Yeah, we took those skin.
And,
how do I know that?
I'm confused. I feel that I am missing something.
You're good.
Okay.
You missed the brain?
Where'd you get that?
Nobody move! Don't
be blind. Oh, it's just, where'd you get that? Damn, son, where'd you find this?
But you see, he brains aside. Will you help me in my quest? If not, you are free to run. I mean, you can try to escape the woods, but they will get you before you do.
So...
die in the woods, go with you, possibly die, but have a higher chance of living.
And 50 gold pieces.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm hearing. I'm hearing is 50 gold pieces per pelt?
No, no, before that.
You can try to escape.
No, before that.
I'm confused with it.
A quest? No!
Where?
I didn't hear half of that.
The deepest of deep cuts.
Yeah, I got some lemon juice if you want it.
Ooh, a quest? Where?
Deck.
I despise that voice.
You're welcome.
I despise that voice. So, you see, as he goes, I freed you all because I sensed the child of the grove was in captivity. That is no place for one of our kind to be. And I sense your presence on all of you, so I freed you all. But I only had room for 5, so I will get the other 2 later.
Yeah, we don't have to worry about
them. They're fine.
We'll get them eventually.
Oh, I was like, meh. See, Rocco is just sitting there like, I think they're coming back for us.
Oh, yeah,
he's just like, where the fuck did they go?
Where the fuck?
No, let's just say they were asleep during the whole thing. They wake up and the cells are just open. You just see nothing but grass and vines. It's like, what the shit?
Yes, exactly that. You see, he goes. If you venture further into wilds, you'll find come. You see, he shifts back into a deer and takes off again. Now, I'm not gonna have you roll because you guys were mostly rolling to not get caught. Had any of you guys failed, you would have been caught. But you succeeded, so We continue. As you guys make your way in, everybody make me nature checks. Hazel with advantage.
18. I got a 9. 19.
Nine? Wouldn't it? With advantage?
With advantage!
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hazel, you're okay, something's wrong. You can't tell what it is. You're just more so. Has this been, when was the last time you met another like druid or somebody with this kind of magic?
Years.
So this is the first time. Yeah, this is the first time that you've actually interacted with a druid in a more formal sense, you know? I mean, obviously, you've been on the ocean. There's not a lot of druids out on the sea. Most of them are terrestrial or like terrain locked. So you've been away from home for a while now. And you're kind of more so overwhelmed with the feeling of nostalgia. It's like when you smell something that brings you back to your childhood. You're just kind of caught in that. But this smell isn't a smell, it's a person, and just kind of the vibes that you're getting from them is just, home. I will say Zircon, I'll say Zircon and Athlyn, you guys are moving about with everybody else. Biggs, Medgar, you guys are mostly making sure that you guys aren't being followed. Zircon, you notice some things aren't lining up. You noticing that the trees are a little bit more decayed and warped. As you get further into the woods, you see that there are like animal carcasses that aren't rotting. Like, they're dead. The animals like fully gored and disemboweled, but there's no signs of decay on them. Not even smell of decay. Athlyn, you're also sensing, I'm gonna say because of your upbringing, you can tell the signs of cult action. Not so much the occult, but like of a cult, you know. And you see that there are like specific markings and engravings in a tree that as you pass by that dictate you are no longer in safe territory anymore. You are now in the territory of a cult, a ancient druidic cult that you can from the signs pointing around you, but that's about all you can assume. And I'm also going to say, you got a 19? I'm also going to say with 19, Zircon, you're noticing the foots, like the specific steps and choices that this dude is making. And with a 19 in your nature check, you're noticing that he's stepping in very specific places. Like he's not stepping where there's like a rotted bark or anything like that. Makes sense when you are familiar with the territory. That's all I'm going to say. So we're going to continue. You guys find yourself in front of a hut. I did not make a map for this, so it's going to be very clear in the mind. You guys find yourself in front of a hut as he stops and starts to step into this clearing. It's around where that, it's like around the base of that hill up there, northwest side. So right about there where that leaf is. Roughly there. you guys have been going about at this for about, I'm gonna say, an hour of travel. You see he steps into the clearing and shifts back to normal, and he goes, "You are now in the domain of the great druid who has created these beasts. I have to ask you, what is your alliance with these people?
Together,
like kin?
I would consider them so.
Okay. I need everybody to make strength saving throws except Hazel.
Strength?
Oh.
Oh, Lord.
Damn it.
Oh, 8.
16. 16, you said?
1.
8. 1.
Oh, no.
You don't, so the only one who saves
could be worse, it could be one.
deer also caught in it. I'm gonna get to you in just a second. See, he looks, he goes,
you associate yourself with these individuals?
Of course I do. Now, can you set them free?
I cannot do that.
Why? What have we done to you?
He's a cult leader!
I'm not a cult leader.
Dude, you're kind of like not chill.
You're like not chill, bro.
Bro, you're not chill. Like, bro, that's not very cash money of you.
They're destroying the green.
I don't know, dude. Seems pretty green to me.
What does that have to do with us?
It has everything to do with us. Our job is to preserve the green. And if they continue to destroy it, there will be nothing for us to preserve.
Okay, so what am I supposed to do?
Stop them.
How?
Wait a second. I don't like that one with the green thing you just said.
And so you see he snaps his fingers, and you hear from the woods behind you the sound of... It sounds like a screech and a roar and a growl all at the same time. So kind of a sound. And you see this thing lands behind him. This thing is disgusting. It is a bizarre blend of body and wings of a falcon with the head of a stag. With the head of a stag. As you see it lands, the shadows it casts are not matching this form. It is a humanoid shadow. And you see this thing opens its mouth. It's got like the teeth of a dog. Like a deer's head with the teeth of a dog as it growls at you and just snaps at the rest of your party.
I'm scared.
You can see he's
slightly aroused.
You see he looks at the party and goes, if you do not choose to protect the green, you can join them in their fate.
Oh, yummy.
You will be the first to turn.
Oh,
damn it, Medgar.
I get to be one of those?
I will help you if you set them free.
Badass, I'll be one of those.
Do you promise?
Of course I promise. I'll set them free.
Oh no.
Let them go.
It's a trap.
You see one of them runs into the house and comes back out with this. You see this dagger with like a crooked, jagged edge. The center is inlaid with a living, growing branch. You see that the leaves are growing. That is a Periton.
Okay.
Yes, that is a Periton.
Okay.
That is what you see flanking him on both sides.
Jesus.
You see a third one emerges from the house with the knife.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them.
The guy and drops in his hand. You see he reaches out. And you see he grabs your hand and pulls the knife to your palm. He goes... slices your hand open and squeezes as
I'm gonna be like 100%.
Squeezes as the blood drips onto the ground and you see a flower blooms from where the blood dropped.
Oh.
And
immediately
withers.
Uh-uh.
And
no.
You see he goes,
that's a disease. I'm pretty sure that's a disease.
You see he goes, the green reveals all.
I hope the green doesn't reveal my library card.
I got an 8.
You got an 8? Okay.
Initiative, you said?
Yes.
Well, it could be worse. You could have gotten a 7.
Oh, yeah. Medgar. Okay.
If it
were worse, you could have gotten a
2.
I got a
5.
Feels bad.
Modify a
20.
Hey!
Damn.
Would be nice to get good rolls. It will be nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Hazel got a 12.
like, all right.
Let's hope.
Now what?
Are we doing this in roll 20 or is this
no,
mind?
This is, I didn't make a this theater of the mind. I didn't make a map for this. So.
Okay.
Then. So with that being said, we're gonna start with Zircon. Start at the top of the initiative order with a strength saving throw. Okay.
This battle music hits hard.
No, I'm like.
I was getting to change it, but then I got distracted.
Okay. What kind of creature is he?
This dude?
Big and scary.
He's a humanoid?
Mm-hmm. Okay. The Paritans are monstrosities.
Am I still... Are we still, like, tied up?
Yeah. That's what the strength saving throw is for.
Oh, okay. So...
So I'm gonna say at the top of your turn, you can make a strength saving throw. If you do not pass, you're restrained.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
No.
Or, like, you can't cast
anything that requires somatics. So if you see a spell, it usually has like VSM. Somatic means like physical hand waving. If it has like a somatic component to it, you cannot cast while you're restrained.
Okay. Alright, let me roll strength. Saving throw?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
Four. Okay, cool.
Okay. Is that my action?
Spell save DC is 12, so you can do very limited things while you're restrained. It's not really what you can do. What do you want to try? Oh, yeah, you can do that.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, your breath weapon, I don't think you need to. So he immediately fails. Oh, she did max damage.
Fuck
oh,
yeah.
It's... Oh, what?
Oh, it's fine.
Yeah. So, do you want to describe this attack?
Yeah. So, I'm like. Fuck with my girl Hazel. So I like, you can see like the warming up my mouth and I blast him like my neck and you see like the vines and stuff around his body.
What's up?
Okay.
Let's
go. Yeah,
you hit him with this like radiant energy. He goes, the green reveals fuck and just gets blasted with the sense of his like dubstep energy. This is gonna be Hazel next. Also I'm gonna give you guys a heads up. Biggs.
Try something different.
Okay.
Than usual. I wanna try and attack with kind of savage.
Oh, leave that out for us.
So it says you channel primal magic to cause your teeth and fingernails to sharpen, ready to deliver a corrosive attack. Make a melee spell attack against one creature within 5 feet of you. On a hit, the target takes 1d10 acid damage after you make the attack, your teeth or fingernails are taken off.
So you're basically wearing
rawr.
Middle school.
Yeah.
Rawr.
Launches at that.
God.
You turn into an e-girl for 5 minutes.
People who have saved your life a number of times and you've saved theirs, you know? You may have known them only for about 2 days, but you owe them your life, and likewise they owe you theirs. So, how dare he step into your little family that you've built? And this anger builds up into an eruption of druidic magic that shifts and turns into this primal savagery you have. And in your anger, in your blind rage of sorts, run at him, and before you can strike, one of the parrotins like flaps their wings and like distracts you, and you miss him. And that is going to be Biggs. Before you do anything, I need you to make a wisdom saving throw. It's gonna be a DC
19.
19, you save. All right, cool. AC, right. The DC is gonna go up by 5 each round.
Lovely. I'm gonna go into rage and hit this dude.
Excellent. So. As this, so here's what happens. Rand, you feel. I'm sorry. Biggs, you feel the magic that was suppressing your lycanthropy fade.
Oh, lovely.
Uh
oh.
And you feel the urge to turn coming on. You don't. You fight it. You suppress it. But you have to continue.
Right.
This urge to come out of the closet.
I'm not Andrew.
Oh! No!
No!
Yo!
That was mean.
Yo.
That was really mean.
But true.
Shout out to Andrew, we love you.
I feel bad.
My man!
No!
Alright, roll to hit.
Valid.
All right,
Andrew's sitting there watching this.
It's a 12.
A 12 hits.
So that's 12 damage.
12?
Because I have a +2 melee damage.
Beautiful. Yeah, do you want to describe how you hit this dude?
So, Big sees all the roots growing up everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
And as it starts growing over him, he's just like, nope, fuck this, Leroy! He takes his axe and just charges the dude and then slashes at his arm.
Okay, yeah, you see, he goes, you just get blasted by radiant energy, goes, the green reveals the immediate. His arm is just gone from elbow down as Big just kind of chops into him.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You fuck, bitch.
That's going to go ahead and be Medgar's turn. Is that the end of your turn?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. There's going to be Medgar then.
Yeah. Do I make it? I have to make a strength saving throw?
As you are still restrained, yes.
Damn.
Oh, hold
18.
On.
18.
Oh, sorry, never mind.
Oh, what's up?
I completely forgot that I have Storm Aura, and he needs to make a DC 13 dex save.
Oh, shit.
Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I will read
I do?
Storm Aura for
yes,
the class.
Please read for the class.
You gain a 10-foot aura effect when you start your rage, and as a bonus action on each of your turns, when activated, one creature of your choice in your aura takes lightning damage. Dexterity DC 13.
He rolls a 12.
Ooh. Oh. So I need to roll 1d6.
Oh shit! If you roll well,
right.
Enough,
just fucking mercs him in 2 turns.
That's 5.
That's a 5.
That's 5.
Finish him.
No.
What? Yeah,
the green reveal.
So here's what happens. It automatically hits.
Yeah.
It always hits. Whether he get if he saves, it get he takes half damage.
Yeah. Right.
So as Biggs cuts this dude's arm off, he's freaking the fuck out. But what he doesn't notice is that from his axe, a charge of electricity just shoots through his arm and then makes his heart explode.
Oh!
And what? Makes his heart explode.
I could say his plan backfired quite quickly.
His arm just cuts and goes. You guys watch the slow motion as it traces up and like in friggin' Avatar just stops right at his heart, and you watch his heart like an X-ray of it, kind of like in Mortal Kombat. Just see him just go ah! And like drop, and you see the Parrytons. They just look, and they look up at y'all, and then they just kind of It's gonna be Athlyn's turn.
Wait, what about me?
Medgar, because we had to rectify that. Forgive me.
I'm so sorry, Steve.
Medgar, that's going to be you.
And my my strength saving throw of 18 still counts?
Yes, it still does. So you burst through, and you have your full action and movement and everything.
Huzzah! All right, so how close is the latest Parryton to me?
They're about 10 feet away from you. So, yeah. Oh, by the way, you just watched this man just get destroyed.
He got burned.
This man just straight up pops in front of me. I'm like, his destruction gave me determination. His destruction gave me determination. That's why I broke through all slow-mo action movie style. So, let's see. So, with that, I'm going to say, can I say that as I'm breaking out, I reach behind me and grab my club and short sword and put them together into my glaive?
Yeah, definitely.
And I'm going to attack them because I have a 10-foot reach with my glaive.
Okay, go for it. 14?
14
hits.
They take 11 damage. Let's see. I'm going to, once I attack him, I'm going to jump back 10 feet as well.
Okay. Sounds good. Alrighty then. That's going to be Athlyn.
So I was reading this, and this says whales from the grave.
Okay.
It says as someone closer to the grave, I'm guessing death,
mm-hmm.
You can channel the power of death to harm someone else as well.
Okay.
So, how close is that other guy to death?
Who, the bird? The Parryton?
Yeah.
Well, he just got hit for 11 hit points. He's not close to death.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And also, it has to be you who, like, drives him. Yeah,
13
saves.
Okay. So I'm restrained, right?
You were no longer restrained.
No.
Yeah, 13 saves.
So attack with dagger to the one that Medgar just attacked.
Okay, go for it. Are you running up to it? Or are you there?
How close am I?
I'm saying you're about 5 feet away from me, so about 15 feet away from me.
15 feet? Okay, that's half my speed. Yeah, so I have about 15 to run up to him. Dagger, 12
that hits. 12 does not hit.
What?
12 does not hit.
Okay. Well, one hit. Next dagger?
Why don't you say yes, because you can bonus action offhand attack.
Yes.
Okay,
for me.
Fuck yeah.
I dropped my SD card.
19, better fucking hit.
That hits.
Okay, so that was...
19 does not hit. Just weeps.
Damage is 5.
5 damage, alright, cool, solid. going to be the druid who's dead. fucking damn, I had a whole plan with this motherfucker and all of
he popped.
Is going to attack with its talons. That is a 10 to hit.
That is a miss.
And Medgar is going to attack you. That is going to be an 18.
yeah, that hits.
Okay, great. You see this thing like slashes at Athlin. It turns around and spears you with its antlers for a total of 6 points of damage.
Can I use Hellish Rebuke as a reaction? Can I cast Hellish Rebuke?
Yes, you can.
All right, let's see. You point your finger, and the creature that damaged you is momentarily surrounded by Hellish Flames. The creature must make a Dexterity saving throw.
Okay, I'm going to make this Dex save real quick. It's got a 18.
Damn it. All right, so it takes 1d10 damage.
1d10?
1d10.
1d10 damage halved, or is it...
No, it's 2d10, but halved if he saves.
Oh, so then roll 2d10, and then we'll divide that by 2.
Okay. Fuck, he takes 2 damage. Wait. Oh! No! That's 14! He takes 7 damage.
Damn. Oh, he is looking hurt. Yeah, this thing spears you with its horns. You, like, grab it, and then, like, these purple and black flames trace from the horns down and, like, cover its body as this thing starts to smell like fried chicken.
Delicious.
That's going to be the next one. It is going to go after Hazel.
Oh, wait. It's not 2d10, it's 3d10 because it's second level. I have to re-roll that. Okay, so just 1d10? Here, let me fix that then.
We'll fix that real quick. So it's the 4 plus the 10 plus the...
Should we do the 5?
We'll say, 4 plus 10 plus 5 is going to be 19. Divide that by 2, that's going to be 9 damage. So, yeah, he's fucking hurt. this thing is very hurt. Meanwhile, the other one is going to go and fly down towards Hazel. It's going to make an attack. Hazel, does a 8 hit?
No.
Okay. Completely misses. And then it gets multi-attack. So it's going to be an 18 to hit.
Yes.
Alright, great. So then that one's going to be, with its talons, that's going to be 9 damage.
Jesus fuck.
You watch as this one flies down and sinks its talons into your back and rips down. And then this last one's gonna go after Biggs. Real quick, Biggs.
Yeah.
Does a 22 hit?
No, I fucking. Yeah, fucking hits! You know it does!
That's gonna be 9 damage from its antlers. Another goddamn 22. And so that's gonna be fucking 8 damage from its talons. So it's gonna be 17 damage altogether. You are raging, so that's halved to 8. This thing is tearing into you. It is not letting
you. You're getting gored.
You are literally, the attack is literally gore. Oh. Literally called gore, You are gored by this deer for 8 points of damage. That is going to be back at the top of Zircon.
It's that wing that
you are still restrained,
right?
So I need you. What?
Yeah. It's that wing deer thing?
Yeah, that wing deer thing. Restrained.
I think
it's 4 or 5.
How big is it? Like,
it's about the size of a man.
Oh,
so what?
Like the body itself is the size of a man?
No, like, kind of like how like a Great Dane is also the size of a man.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Like, if it were standing up and, like, reaching its arms up, it would be 6 feet tall. That body, that torso and everything is about 3-4 feet tall.
Okay.
You know, its wingspan is about the size of the
world. Still pretty terrifying.
It's still pretty terrifying. Imagine, like, something, you know, the size of a small, no, medium to large sized dog just, you know.
I reach for my cock.
Oh, okay.
Look on, just like,
interesting twist.
Good old dick twist.
Pause.
Good old dick twist.
Dick twist. Him with a dick twist, twist his dick.
Still within range.
No, I was like, whoop.
Yeah, so, but you're still within range, so.
But I can be like, whoop, and then I run.
Okay, sure. Well, Medgar's the only one who's technically not in range, so. Medgar.
I can help, sir.
Oh, wait, you and are both back. Not yeah. So, yeah, that's the end of your turn.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wait.
What did you do?
I didn't do anything.
Exactly, you failed your strength saving throw, so you're still strong.
So I can't do anything?
Can she use her breath weapon again?
Can I still use my breath?
Yeah, blow up another person. Make them pop.
You have another chance. You have another beast.
Yeah, I
think
I have
your breath weapon. Okay. Sure thing, yeah.
Okay. Well, first I'm going to send a telekinesis message to everyone in the party.
You can do that?
Yeah.
That's
I don't know why I haven't used this.
You just want me to in the grave.
Let's not talk about it.
You go ahead and,
you're in the dungeon.
At least one language to comprehend these messages.
So that is does not require an action, so you are free to do it.
So I'm gonna say, help me. And then, and then there's one bird, deer, whatever thing.
There's three of them.
No, but like one perch still?
Oh, no, all three of them are fully like attacking.
Okay.
Yeah.
Isn't one dead?
One of them is not. Oh,
no,
one
I thought
is not
one
dead.
Of them
one
was
is hurt, but it's not dead.
The one that
the dude is dead.
That exploded.
The dude is dead.
Oh.
Yeah, dude popped.
Only
but there's three. There's three dude Parringtons or whatever.
Exploded. Dude man had the heart attack of all heart attacks.
Oh.
Light Yagami was like, yes, I'm doing it, and the man got Light Yagami'd.
Yeah, okay, then no.
Okay.
My man got Light Yagami'd.
So
very tragic.
Yeah, that's
very sad times. Yes, indeed.
That's gonna be Hazel.
So for one of my actions, it says channel divinity, charm animals, and I'm assuming it's creatures, it doesn't show me the rest of it.
Okay.
And it says as an action, you can use channel divinity and present your holy symbol to charm for 1 minute each beast or plant creature that can see you within 30 feet.
This is a monstrosity, so it does not fall under those
no.
ramifications now.
Okay.
Beast and plant are specific monster types. And
right.
Monstrosity is another one that's completely separate. Keratins do not fall under that.
Alright, well then I'm going to cast Guiding Bolt at second level. That's going to be what I'm trying.
So, A, B, or C?
Who's the most?
Let's go for the one that's like the most.
A is the most fucked up. So.
Yeah, let's go for A.
Okay. That hits.
Fuck yeah. 17 damage.
Do you want to describe how you finish this?
Fuck yeah.
I'm gonna. You can go ahead.
Finish him.
You send out another witch. Was it guiding bolt?
Yeah.
You build up this druidic energy in your hand, and you shoot it out. As this thing hits this periton, it was on fire, and now it turns into a beautiful topiary, where each of the flames is replaced by like a beautiful black and purple flower. Uh-huh. And it smells of spring air.
Oh, that's nice.
That's gonna be Biggs. I need you to make that wisdom saving throw for me. It's gonna be a DC 15.
I failed.
Tragic sentence.
Biggs.
Yeah.
Do you want to describe a transformation?
No.
No.
Oh God.
Oh God. Biggs, as you strike this pathetic wimp of a man, you see blood trickling out of his mouth.
The music for this part is perfect.
And you smell it.
The deliciousness of it.
There's just something about it that's just... It drives you
savor
out of your mind. And you're trying to suppress it. But you can't. Your lust for blood is unquenched. And you feel yourself losing consciousness. You lose your control of your body as you become a backseat driver to a final state. You guys watch as Biggs begins to shift and transform. He like almost doubles in size.
Oh.
As his hair begins to like just grow all over his body. See his like nails.
Kinky.
His face morphs into like an elongated canine snout, and you see a tail just tear through his pants and shoot out the end.
Can I cast salmon?
Gross.
On your turn. Biggs, I need you to attack. Just roll to. Well, what are you going to do? You are going to attack, I assume.
Yeah.
Great. I just need you to roll to hit.
Eight.
Oh. Eight. Alright, excellent.
But don't forget, whoever I attacked also has to get a DC 13.
No, that's if you scratch or bite them. You are currently wielding...
I'm talking about Storm Aura, dude.
Oh, Storm Aura? Even if you miss?
Yeah. Okay, you gain a 10-foot aura effect when you start your rage as a bonus action on each of your turns. When activated, one creature of your choice in your aura takes lightning damage.
Ooh, this is going to be interesting. Oh. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm going to real quick roll d6.
The look of the dice, bitch.
Let's see who gets it. Zircon.
What the fuck? I'm so tied up.
Yeah, so
Dex save.
You get, hold on, sorry, forgive me. You, as far as the dex saves go, you are restrained, so if I'm correct in my assumption, you immediately fail dex saving throws. This creature has disadvantage on dexterity saving throws. So, you need to roll dex save with disadvantage or you take all the damage.
Dex save?
Mm-hmm.
How do you do disadvantage?
You go to the skill. Oh, yeah, the dexterity, you hold it down. No, the square. Hold down the square and then disadvantage.
Oh.
Oh, no shit. I didn't know you could do that.
Fails.
How much does she take, Gabe?
Oh, Lord. From my own.
4 damage.
4. Okay. Yeah, lightning cackles as you see your friend transform into this lightning and, like, screeches in, like, rage as lightning crackles from him and arcs out. Everyone kind of dodges out of the way, but it just strikes at Zircon as she is restrained.
You don't know what you're doing,
Jace. Medgar, that is you.
I have a question.
Yes.
Am I within 30 feet of Biggs?
You are, yes.
Does Biggs qualify as a creature, a humanoid creature?
Yes, he does.
I would like to cast Charm Person.
Let's go.
Charm Person for the class?
What was the question?
Re-charm person for the class?
You attempt to charm a humanoid you can see within range. It must make a wisdom saving throw and does so with advantage if you or your companions are fighting it. If it fails the saving throw, it is charmed by you until the spell ends or until you or your companions do anything harmful to it. Would you say that we're attacking it or it's fighting us? Would that count?
I'm going to say it's neither, so I'm not going to have big roll with advantage.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm just going
to... Charm creature regards you as a friendly acquaintance. When the spell ends, the creature knows it was charmed by you. When you cast this spell using a spell slot of second level or higher, you can target one additional creature for each slot level above first. The creatures must be within 30 feet of each other when you target them. So I'm going to commit Charm Person on Biggs and one of the Parringtons.
One of the Parringtons are not humanoids, they are monstrosities.
Oh, never mind then. Then I will just commit it on, I will just do it to Biggs.
Wisdom saving throw, what's the DC he has to beat?
He has to beat, it's a wisdom saving throw, he has to beat 14.
You want to get under 14 to not attack Medgar.
That is 14 on the dot.
He saves. You want to describe how you try charming this person?
Okay, so essentially what happens is I see Big start freaking out and I freaking try to jump to action and I say something into my hands and then force it outwards towards Biggs and it's just like, it just hits his head and poof.
Delicious.
Food, glorious food. Fried, roasted, or stewed. Glorious food, wonderful food. My beloved husband.
You might need it.
Yeah. I can provide life insurance. Oh, damn.
Is it through Liberty Mutual, so you only pay for what you need?
Not sponsored by Liberty.
Not sponsored by Liberty.
Okay. Can I roll insight?
Sure you can. Remember, you still got these other two monster birds in the area.
You're right. How close is Biggs to me?
About 10 feet away from you.
Rand, why do you have to save?
On your ass.
Oh, one touch my ass? Awesome. Okay.
Not touching it, but it's close.
Okay, I'm gonna go for him then.
Okay.
Dagger!
Yeah, that hits. I watched that pop up on your screen. I'm like, huh.
Okay. Ibumba.
7 damage. Yeah, this is the first time.
I still have other dagger.
Go for it. Yeah.
Kick him in his balls.
25 from the dagger.
Go, yeah, go ahead and roll that.
Holy shit.
Ibumba.
I told you, kick him in the balls. Do it.
14, maybe.
You, wow, okay, yeah, this thing is hurt. Do you want to describe it? You hit it?
Yeah, so he, as you said, he's on my ass, so he is trying to grope my ass.
You see a talon just kind of coming closer into the ear, just like.
So as it comes in, I sense it, because I have spider sense. Sorry, cult sense. And I grab his hand, I break it, take out one dagger, put it into his arm, rip all the way down from here.
It's a bird.
It's a bird?
It's like a bird beard.
Well, I take his talon.
Okay. Well, I'm just gonna stop you right there.
And I grab his arm hoof talon thing. You know where the joint is, where it moves?
Yeah.
I stab there and go straight down so his arm splits in two.
Oh.
Take my other dagger and I shove it into his
wing collarbone. Yeah.
And then I rip out.
Oh, okay. Great. In that case, yeah, this thing's
so cool. Now he has five legs.
Ew.
Yeah.
That is going to be that bird's turn. It did not like what you did to it, so
too bad.
It's going to go ahead and attack you.
Suck a dick.
That's going to be a 10 to hit.
Fuck you!
And another 10 to hit! Wow!
This
thing is hurt so bad it can't even attack properly. That's the end of its turn. That's going to go ahead and be this next one. It's going to go after Hazel. That is a modified 20 to hit. Mm. Bam.
Yeah.
Sorry.
And the other one is a modified 23 to hit. So that's going to be.
Oh, I'm down for the count,
oh,
y'all.
Wait, it's how much damage? 10?
19.
I'm so sorry.
You see this thing?
You're laughing. She's dead.
Skewers Hazel. Ah, see this thing scratches at Hazel, skewers her, and like flips her body over. You watch as like a trail of like blood splatters into the air, and she lands with a heavy thud.
Wait. Her blood lands from the ground. Does that mean it withers?
No, it doesn't. It was,
that'd be really cool.
It was the blade that like did that whole thing. So, yeah.
That'd be really cool to do though.
I'm gonna die. Her blood.
Okay, Zircon, that is your turn.
Fuck.
How many hit points do you have left?
I'm dead. Zero.
She's at zero, so she has to make death
saves. I
wasn't
kidding. I'm dead.
Death saves,
so
bro.
Death saves next. Okay.
Shit.
Damn.
Strength saves, bro.
You are still restrained. Or is it?
Hey. I can't even do anything.
Agony.
That's going to be Hazel. I need you to roll a d20. If you get 10 or higher, that's a pass. If you get 9 or lower, that's a fail.
Danny, do the vines that are constricting people, do they have health points? She's gonna get two. She's gonna get two ones.
I'm gonna say it doesn't count. So you rolled a 9 plus
2 plus 2.
Plus 9 plus 4. This 13 saves. You finally break out of these. Yeah, you. Gosh. Okay.
Hell
you
yeah.
Survived this.
That's fantastic.
Okay.
Good job.
What?
Not you, Hazel.
Oh.
Still say it's at zero. Zircon, you watch Zircon. You watch as Hazel drops. You sense like life is escaping her as the grass around her begins to wither. You enter this like point where you're like, no, that's not right. This isn't how her story is supposed to end. And you. Reach deep inside of you and burst open as they hit. So yeah, burst from the vines. And what do you do?
Okay,
any kind of like healing or whatever.
Yeah.
Absolutely do that.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna spare five. Can I do that?
You can do that. Yeah.
You touch all the creatures that have zero hit points.
That means you passes all her death saves.
Yeah.
Okay. Are just asleep now. So you go ahead, you do that. That is a cantrip, so you don't have to worry about burning a spell slot. Hazel, you're fine. You're not dead.
Yeah.
That is on her. That is Hazel's turn now. Hazel, you, much like everyone else, you get 0 hit points and you death save throws. You no longer find yourself where you were. Instead, you find yourself. beautiful sounds around you, of like the leaves rustling and water babbling on a brook and birds singing. The air smells cleaner than you've ever sensed it before. I wouldn't change the music just yet. You see, from the leaves comes this person, a face, almost like it's a sketchy, like, FaceTime, made of leaves. And you see, they look at you and they go, "It's not your turn. Not yet." And you feel yourself come back to your body. Biggs!
Damn, I thought it was my turn.
Make a wisdom saving throw, DC 10. It resets every time you fail.
Modified 20!
Wow, yeah, you saved. You snap back into, like, yourself. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. You are... the first thing you see is Zircon hit the ground, and, Zircon hit the ground, like, smacks Hazel with this energy that you just see, restores her, and, you see Hazel's, like, body as, like, the wounds caused by this Periton goring her close up. And you see these two Periton who are flapping around, like, watching.
Do I still have the healing potion?
Yes.
Okay. Am I in human or am I...
You are still werewolf.
I'm still werewolf?
Yes.
So I have none of my belongings.
Yes. Also, forgot to mention, you have a plus one to your AC.
Okay.
And you are still, like, wielding your, axe and everything.
Okay.
And you are still raging.
Do I have any bonuses to strength or anything like that while I'm in the werewolf?
Because your strength score is already higher than the one that it would turn to, I would say no.
I'm going to go ahead and smack the other demonic bird thing.
Go for it.
So that's going to be 12.
That hits. No, that does not hit. It just misses.
Lose head times. Absolutely tragic.
Stormora?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dex save 13.
Okay, it makes a dex save of natural 20.
Okay, so it's only half.
Yep.
So, 2 damage.
Wow, okay, cool. So, it just, a little bit of lightning crackles on it. That's all. It's going to be Medgar.
So, the closest Parrington to me.
Yes.
How close is it, would you say?
Within, I want to say 10 feet?
That's the one in between me, right?
Yes, it is.
Well, what kind of warlock would I be if I didn't use Eldritch Blast?
Let's do it.
13.
That hits.
2 damage.
2 damage. Alright.
Sometimes you scare me.
That's going to be the one that was attacked.
Good.
Athlin. Speaking of, Athlin, it's your turn.
That was the worst turn ever.
Yeah.
No more adventuring for you.
The wind just kind of goes, no.
Fuck you.
I do not vibe.
It's not.
I just fucking shot myself. Not a vibe.
Daggers haven't really failed me yet, so. Hey, Boomba.
Never say. Oh, 15. Actually, 15 hits, yeah. I was about to say, never say never, but damn. Yeah.
This is a first for everything.
That is a 7. First one gets in, second one,
it dodges.
I'm gonna say, either dodges or, like, there's blood on my hand, so, like, slips out of my hand, or whatever.
That's perfect, yeah.
whatever.
Yeah. So, oh, by the way, I'm gonna say with that, you, like, watch your knife slip, and you kind of, like, lose the balance of it, grab it, and you're watching the shadows. It's not you fighting this bird, it's you full-on fighting a dude. Like, this guy's hand up, your shadows, like, catching it.
Wait, hold on, what?
Yeah, the shadows don't line up with this bird's thing. The shadows are humanoid shadows.
Yeah, he said that when we first started. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're like humanoid.
Yeah. So
the birds?
The shadows are. Not the birds, but the shadows are.
spell against
you. There are still monstrosities.
But could he do a human spell against the shadows themselves?
That's some shadow magic there, but the shadows are not creatures. They are just projections of creatures, so I'm going to say no. But that was a good idea. Good idea. It's going to be the next one. It's going to go ahead and going to attack Biggs. As a 7 to hit.
Miss. Do you still have that psychic link?
As another 7 to hit. Jeez.
Okay, so can I relay that information?
Yeah, definitely.
Across the board? Okay, guys, don't kill the other two. Just cripple them. That sounds really bad. But trust me.
Okay.
Okay, Zerk on to you.
Got it.
Alright. So are all the Paritons, like...
One's dead.
One's dead.
One is hurt, and the other one has hardly been touched.
Where is the one that's hardly been touched?
It is,
Is it in the air?
It is attacking, Biggs.
Okay. I'll go and help Biggs. And I'm going to cast Tasha's Mind Whip.
Okay, and make a flex save. Intelligence.
Ah, I always say that. I'm sorry.
And they have a minus one to int.
Int.
What is the save? Well. Okay. It's a 7?
Yes.
Okay.
Four?
Only 4. Okay, so that's what it's called. Okay, so he takes it, you know. Do you want to describe your Tosh? Your mind to it? Okay, yeah. You, with the psychic energy, the same energy you can communicate with your teammates, lash out a force of energy that just kind of smacks this bird as it goes. And so that is going to then be Hazel, still out for the count. Biggs. Make that wisdom save. You gotta beat a 15.
I did not.
Nope. Alright, cool. Roll to attack.
15.
Okay, so I believe that hits almost everybody on the board, so that's going to be a 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to roll a d4, see who you hit. That is a 4. You hit the bird. Roll damage.
That would be modified 10.
10 damage, beautiful.
And the dex save, DC 13.
Dex save's got plus 1 to dex. Got a 4.
So it takes all of 1 damage.
Got it.
Ooh.
Yeah. So yeah, you see the pupils kind of dilate on Biggs as he reaches for the bird and just attacks it. That is then going to be Medgar.
Oh, okay. All right, so how are my Paringtons looking?
The Paringtons are looking hurt.
Both of them?
Yes, both of them are looking hurt.
Okay, I'm going to go up to the one closest to me. I'm going to use my glaive and try to go as an undersweep to cut their legs off.
Okay.
14.
14 hits.
That is 10 damage.
10 damage to which one? The one that, which one?
Whichever one's closest to me.
Okay, cool. Is that lethal or non-lethal?
I'm gonna say non-lethal because, I was told to cripple them. Okay. I am just being a kind person.
You cripple one to a incapacitation. You, hit it at 0.
Alright, I cut his legs off. So, can I say what happened then?
Yes.
Okay, so, right after, right after Aethlyn is like, excuse me, hold on. I got my train of thought again. After Aethlyn tells everyone telepathically, okay, just cripple them,
don't kill them, I'm like, I bet. And so I like do this funny little run with my glaive and I like bend down and do the unnecessary spin from Book of Boba Fett, except with the glaive, and I cut off the ones closest to me, both of his legs.
Okay. Do the real quick spin, this bird is like, fucker, you, and you cut off his legs, and goes, oh, that's what you're doing.
The bird's like, that was an unnecessary spin. Oh, my legs. Literally, though, Anakin Obi fight. Aslan has left this plane.
Aslan is not here.
Aslan.
Aslan.
I'm sorry.
It's Ash boy.
We'll go ahead and loop back around to him. It's going to be the bird. The bird is going to then go ahead and attack Biggs. Hope it fucking fails. That is a 12 to hit.
Misses.
And that is a 8 to hit.
Misses.
This thing is so overwhelmed by you and your sheer just force and
girth
that it is trying to attack, but you're just overwhelming it with all of your like hits. Like at one point it does get a claw on you, but you grab it and you just kind of like throw it into the ground.
Bitch, please.
Oh man.
You thought you could touch me? You thought you could touch me on my streets?
I really thought.
It would have been perfect timing 10 minutes ago.
Okay.
This sentence.
Okay, who's left?
Just the bird.
Just one dude?
Yep.
Cool. Is anyone killed?
Steve, decapitated. Steve crippled one.
I was like, so he's dead. Okay. You could have just said yes.
Steve crippled one to 0 hit points.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to... How close is the other one?
It's within 10 feet.
Okay, how does he look?
He's looking under half.
Okay. I'm going to attack him with that, you go.
Okay. Yeah, hits. Is that not? No, it's not.
No.
That does it. 5 damage. It's still up.
Okay, unarmed strike.
Okay.
Oh, 11.
Does not hit.
Okay.
So, yeah. Zircon, this one be you.
Not to cripple him, but.
I'm gonna use Witchbolt. I say, that sounds deadly. And just go, ah!
Bird go, and just turns into a full rotisserie. Just
we gotta
drops.
Eat something for dinner tonight.
Feels bad, feels bad.
Honestly, yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
Well, he might be humanoid, so.
So you see, one of the birds is there. It's. What is this thing? You guys are out of combat.
Okay.
Say this, Zircon, real quick, roll me a insight check.
Do I need to roll anything else because I still am werewolf?
Yeah, I need you to roll a wisdom saving throw.
Oh, so we're not out of combat.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, depending on what he rolls.
It's a 10.
Nope.
Oh!
So that's a natural 1 modified to 6.
So yeah, you go to strike at someone and you just slip on a Perryton carcass and miss.
Fuck yeah.
Wait. Can you slip on the guy that was crippled?
Yes!
The crippled guy crippled him.
Break one of his wings.
Double cripple.
You cannot fly. You get for the insight. Six. Okay, yeah, you're not getting as much.
Oh, Sean. Or no,
everybody except Biggs can roll insight.
I was gonna say, dude.
What about me?
Does someone need to roll for Stormwater?
Oh.
No.
Okay.
Is it for insight?
Yeah.
Fourteen,
that's gonna be enough. You know that you can, like, essentially, I'm gonna say that you can do ceremony now.
Okay.
Work with them, so you're not in combat anymore. You're going to help people, so you need a strength. You need, like, a strength check from someone to hold him down, and you need to basically do the ceremony.
I guess I'll try to hold him down here.
Okay.
Strength save is a 12.
You can roll with advantage.
Okay. So is it base strength or is it strength save?
It's a strength check, so just base save. I mean, base strength roll.
Do I roll a strength save?
You roll a strength save.
Okay, I do have advantage on strength checks.
I have a 10.
Okay, so that's a 10. Did you roll that with advantage?
Yes.
Okay, so yeah, that's a 10 with you and Zircon holding him down.
That's a nat 20, so 25.
Oh.
You!
Yo!
Watch as you guys try to hold Biggs down, he just throws you guys.
Damn.
Like, fully just chucks you guys back. Fine. Yeah, that's a crit.
But it's just for a save, so it's okay.
Still. So yeah, Biggs, that's you. I need you to roll a wisdom save.
I make Wilhelm scream as I get thrown into a tree.
I'm so sorry. I'll let you know I'm good. It's an 18.
18. You save. Yeah, you come to as you just launch your friends.
Sorry.
In this moment, he's a willing creature. So
where's that from?
Oh, it's from Emperor's New Groove.
Sorry.
Oh yeah.
You're saying
what's his name?
Shout out to Emperor's New Groove.
No!
Enough shouting.
Cusco!
I'm not gonna do any of this shit. I'm not gonna link anything. Fuck you guys. Link it up yourself.
I'm not gonna link to the Emperor's New Groove. It's just the Emperor's New Groove. The mouse will sue us.
The mouse.
The
mouse gets enough money.
Yeah.
I see.
But yeah, so you can cast ceremony now.
Okay. I cast ceremony.
Okay, great. So what is it that you're doing exactly?
So
which aspect of ceremony are you casting?
Atonement.
He's skipping around me, throwing flower petals.
Yes. You have to roll?
It's just a flat 20.
Okay.
Save him.
Free him. Enslaved bird, free him.
Wisdom insight check. My bad.
An insight check of DC 20. So you have to beat a 20. You have to hit or beat a 20 with your insight check.
But he does.
The willing creature?
Oh, and you make a DC wisdom insight check.
So you have to make the insight check of DC 20.
Okay, so insight.
Yes.
Come on, baby.
You need a. If you have a 16, you have a plus 6. You need a 14 or higher in order to get it.
That's I believe in you.
That's a 22.
I believed in you.
You got a 22.
Nice.
Alrighty then. What do you say to Biggs?
Who the fuck, man?
My ding ding dong. My ding ding dong.
It still shows up in my like playlist.
How? I. Okay.
No, kind of like how what Steve did with his like he talks into his hands and then does that so no one else hears it.
Okay, Biggs.
And I put it right up to his ears.
Biggs, how do you react to this?
I don't even care like, no, man. I'm just in shock.
I'm assuming that you just kind of snap out of it, and you now have full control of your body.
Sweet. Is he still like in werewolf?
He's still in werewolf form.
Oh, badass.
He has control for the night. He has control of his body for the night.
With the fucking hammer? Oh, yeah. Or the axe?
Yes.
That's badass. Steve, we need a werewolf holding a great axe.
And that is where we will end our session.
Oh,
yes.
can I heal?
Oh, yes, you
100%
can.
Can we bring her back? Wait,
yes, you can do that. You can do that. Yeah, we don't end session, man.
Hold on. Before you do that.
That's where we end our session. Hazel just lying on the ground, practically dead.
Potion, would that immediately bring her back? And then we can...
She's yeah. been, she wanted to cast Cure Wounds, right?
But it, I don't know.
Okay, well, I mean...
Well, because
so,
if you do that...
Yeah, you can go ahead and
yeah,
get the potion.
We don't know if you'll need another long rest, so we can...
Give the potion.
So I'm just going to go ahead and give that to her, and then that brings her back to what, 5 or something like that? Or
we'll
1d4. 1d4?
It's like, I think it's 1d4 plus 4.
I thought it was 3d4. 2d4 plus 4. That's
oh,
what
wait, is that what it says on the thing?
I don't know. I don't have it in my inventory. I've
oh,
never
if you don't have it in your inventory, then
okay.
So you don't. If you don't have it in your inventory, you don't.
I could have sworn I added it to my inventory, though.
I will check your inventory.
I do. I was looking at it. It's not there because I know I already took the rope out. So
okay,
I gave
we're
that
gonna,
to
we're gonna say it was confiscated.
Okay.
So yeah, you don't have the health potion.
Although
so
natural memories in the forest we can use.
You gotta roll a good nature check to figure that out.
Okay.
Wait, what potion was that anyways?
It was just a standard healing potion.
Oh.
I can roll nature, but I have a plus one.
And then just roll tap the thing. Nope. You're not gonna find
it. I rolled
anything.
A 10.
I didn't find it.
I grabbed the mushroom.
You bounce back for 6 hit points as a Zircon. Would you want to describe how you heal Kingsley?
Clear! Grabs two hedgehogs, runs together. Clear!
Just this hedgehog is running through the wall.
That's how I do it. I give the hedgehog a little radius.
What and sucks is that they
Thank
stick
you.
To her. They're all pokey. Just boom.
They just keep charging.
They're just glowing golden hedgehogs at this point. They just run off at supersonic speeds.
There's a golden radiant. Like Tron.
I was thinking more Sonic,
hedgehogs.
But yeah.
I'm thinking Tron.
Okay.
Sonic.
Tronic. There you go.
Okay.
And that is where we will end our session. Thank you so much for watching. We will be back in our abodes later. Thank you for joining us, and we will see you later. Bye-bye!